Hello, hello, hello. Welcome. Welcome, welcome to Burning Bowl Ceremony 2020, Unity of Nanaimo. It's a great pleasure for me to be here with you. We are trying out some new technology today. And I certainly hope it is working. I've got a number of things, buttons and stuff that I'm pushing, but I know it's all going to be great. It's all going to work out beautifully. And yeah, it's time. It's that time of year where we get to reflect. We get to look back. We get to ask that question of what no longer serves. What could we let go of? What can we say, all right, that's enough. It's time to leave that behind, say thank you, and then move forward. So this new technology here, it's exciting. I can actually see some of the text in here. It's fantastic. So let's take a moment together and just settle into where we are. We're going to spend the next 30 to 45 minutes together. We're going to call upon ourselves internally to release and let go. And then once we've created that space, we're going to invite something new in. Because here's the beautiful thing is when we let go of things, when we create that space, something new can come in. Something new can take shape, can be planted. And I don't know about you, but for me, I'm ready. I'm really ready to take care of that. And here's what we want to bring to this. We want to bring grace. We want to bring in self-care, some compassion, some forgiveness, and we want to bring in love. Yes, as Leanne says, I release and I let go. I let spirit run my life. Yeah, that's what there is here for us to do. So we welcome peace. We welcome love. We welcome grace. We welcome inclusivity. We welcome our differences. And we say welcome to one another as we support each other on this journey. The beautiful thing about a community is just that we get to be together. We get to support one another. We get to lean on one another. It's that idea of, as we let our light shine, we give permission for others to do the same. We light the path, if you will. And speaking of lighting the path, as we begin to settle in a little more, I would like to take this opportunity to light this candle. And this candle has been with me on my desk for 2020 through various classes and ceremonies. And this will be its last use. And so with that, I invite you to just take a moment and allow this candle to be that light, that Christ spirit in each one of us. And to allow it to burn brightly as we step into this ceremony together. And then at the end of our ceremony, we'll close it off and welcome a new light and a new candle for 2021. So a couple of things. If you don't already have these things, you're going to need something metal is the best, a metal pot or a metal bowl that you will be able to burn a piece of paper in. I myself have a number of these singing bowls. I find that I have one in particular that has become my sacred bowl for this ceremony, as I've used it a number of times. So you'll want definitely a bowl of some kind that's metal preferred. You'll need some matches. You'll need some paper. The thinner the paper, the better. However, if you did get your package from Unity, you already have, I believe, two cards in your package. One of them, you know, on both sides is the opportunity to write something. So on one side we have, I release the following, etc. On the other side we have, I am open to being guided to actions. So one of the cards we will use to write down what we're releasing and letting go of, and we'll burn that. And if you have some thin paper, you're welcome to use that as well. And then the second card or piece of paper we will use to begin the process of creating what we need to create, what we want to create for 2021. And the thing about that, if I can just add, is that this can go on for the rest of the day. It can be added to tomorrow, can be added to the next day. Allow yourself the space to continue to build on that opening, to continue to build on creating what there is for you to create for the year ahead. To allow, as Leanne put it, to allow spirit to come in and guide. Yes, I'm going to just add here, I see Tiffany wrote, letting go of 2020 with love and compassion and welcoming a new world, new frequencies, and more love for 2021. Yeah, exactly. You know, this is where we can lean on each other. Again, I have found in doing live ceremonies, live talks where there's interaction, I learn so much. We get to learn from each other, and it's a beautiful community. So along with our safety, we also want to make sure that we're safe, that anything we're calling forth from within, anything that needs to be released, we give ourselves that grace, that self-care. We give ourselves permission to do so. And along with that is going to be things that, you know, maybe it's pain. Maybe there's some pain in our thinking, in our body. Maybe it's, you know, I could have or I should have. Maybe it's why me or why not me? You know, these sort of conversations that might be coming up for us. It might also be something that has worked really well in the past, but it's no longer working. And it might be time to let go of that. You know, like that really old, wonderful sweater that is full of holes now and just doesn't look very good on us anymore. It might be time to let go of that. It's served its course for us. It's run its course, served us, and we might want to let go. And so today's intention is to call forth that which no longer serves us. And to do that, we want to go within. Now in Unity, we have these beautiful 12 powers, and one of them is the power to release, the power to let go. And that is located down here in our lower abdomen. Its color is russet. And what we want to do is we want to go within, and we want to dig in and call upon spirit to begin to release, to allow that freedom to, for whatever comes up, to find its way into the pen in our hand and to write it down on the paper. Don't want to judge it. We don't want to think, oh, I could have written it better, or maybe it should have been that word or this word. Just allow yourself to freely flow and to call from within. At the same time, we want to open up our heart space. We want to open that up to love and acceptance and to allow what there is to flow. So release is that, in the perfect context, it's to eliminate, it's to remove, it's to denounce. And now the great thing about the 12 powers and release being one of them is we have these things. You know, we know, if I asked you the question, do you know that you have the ability to let go? You would likely say, yeah, I do, you know, but if we don't give it attention, this goes for all the 12 powers, if we don't actually call them in to being and give them attention, then they're just hanging around. They're not serving us at the level they could serve us. And so what might happen is, in the case of release, there might be too little of our attention on it, in which case we become maybe a hoarder. We fear lack, so we accumulate things. And then if there's too much, if we're just too much in the camp of release, we might just purge things, eradicate. You know that saying, throw out the baby with the bathwater. It's like even something that's serving us really well, we might hastily get rid of it and then think back, oh, why did I do that? So when we call attention and consciousness to these 12 powers, to the power of release, now we're working with it, and we can elevate ourselves to a higher consciousness in it. We are now being served by it instead of serving it. So let us begin. I invite you to get comfortable. If you're seated or if you're laying down, just make sure you're straight, your spine is straight. And let's just begin by breathing in. And as we breathe in, just raise our shoulders up to our ears and then drop them down as we let go. Just allow your breath to move freely, and I invite you to breathe in through your nose so that we call that breath inward into our lower belly. We can feel our belly rise and fall with our breath. Just allow yourself to settle. We want to begin to ask that question. What am I calling forth to let go of? What is mine to let go? Now I'm going to invite you to take your piece of paper and hold it in your hand. And if you're comfortable, close your eyes. If you're uncomfortable closing your eyes, I invite you to find a spot on the floor just in front of you or the table, just a couple of feet in front, and drop your gaze. And just feel that paper in your hands. Notice how light it is in weight. And although the burdens and challenges and the things that we're going to call forth today may carry in your heart as heavy, this piece of paper has the ability to carry all of that weight. This piece of paper can take all that we need to release and carry it for us. And so as we take a few moments here, a couple of minutes together, to begin to call forth what is ours to let go of, As things come up, I invite you to write them down. Don't judge them, don't question them, just allow your pen to flow. And we'll take a couple of minutes together. I'll put on some music in the background. As we spend time asking that question, release and let go. I release the following limiting beliefs or thoughts and feelings from my consciousness. Remembering that this piece of paper can carry the weight of all that we want to release and let go of. Could be a word, sentence, could be a combination of words. Maybe it's a way of being, things that have happened. And if you feel there's more and you're out of time to write, you can speak into the paper. You can speak those words into it. But now comes the time where we get to burn the paper. And with that, as we do that, I invite you to see the flame as a new beginning. See whatever it is you're letting go rise up in the smoke into the ethers and allow it to be. Resist the temptation to think, oh, what else didn't I put in there, or I should have put that in, or I forgot that. Know that everything you've put in there now, everything you've put down on that piece of paper now, is exactly what needs to be there. This is that trust in yourself, that grace, that self-love. So if you're ready, again, safely, I invite you to burn your paper. If it's unsafe right now, you can always tear it up, put it aside, and when we're finished this, you can go outside and burn it. Or you can allow your thoughts to be in what I'm going to burn here as ceremonial for you. But remember to be safe as we do this. Know that you are safe and fully supported in this moment. Thank you. I will share, for me, my choice was to give up judgment. If you're comfortable, you can share in the chat what you decided to release. You don't have to, but again, in community, it's always beautiful when we share together. And now let's take a moment now to return into the silence. Ah, thank you, Reverend Patricia. I am now free of vanity and impatience. Ah, lovely. So let's take a moment now to return. Oh, Beverly, judgment as well. Awesome. Yeah. Free of having to be right. So now we're going to return and fill that space with something new. And maybe it comes to you today, maybe it comes later. Here's what I can advise you to do, is to not only write something down on this new piece of paper where, you know, I'm open to being guided to actions, words, and thoughts that attract the following good to me. That's one thing you could look at. You could write down a new way of being. You could write down a goal for yourself, something that you want to accomplish. But the point is, I also want you to add, and everything else, to add, and everything else that comes along. And that way, as things come up throughout today, tomorrow, maybe the next day, as more stuff rushes in on this new possibility, this new way of being for you, we've kind of covered it. We've allowed it to be in our space, in our consciousness. And I'll just share a few more. I let go of my need for perfection and love myself as I am. Negative self-talk, controlling others' choices, judgments, fear, self-judgment, and confinement. I release any doubts in myself, and no spirit will be with me for eternity. Yeah, these are all beautiful things, and we can all embrace those things too. I know as I read those are things that come up for me on an ongoing basis. I'm somehow have a shield up against all of this stuff. I mean, I do, spirit guides me. However, there's moments when these things pop in. I'm free of control and self-judgment. Yeah, it's great. It's so great to have this space. And now let's return to the silence for a moment. Let's return back and see what we can invite in. And as we do that, I want to bring in a quote that Michael Beckwith gave us. I'll put it up on the screen here. In our lives, we are pushed by pain until we come to a point when we allow ourselves to be pulled by a vision. That's what this opportunity is. Now we're going to call on our power of imagination. And you know you have the power, you have the power to dream. You know you have the ability to imagine things. You know that. And sometimes we imagine things that aren't very good for us. But in this moment, this is where we get to imagine powerful, beautiful things for ourselves. Again, practicing self-love and self-care, asking, what is mine to do? Patricia spoke last week about the difference between vision and visualization. This is a moment when we can ask, what is mine to do? Allow yourself to have a calling come in, and then continue that work and continue into visualization as well. What are the things that you do want in your life? And journal these things down. When we write them down, it does something to us. It not only hits us up here when we think about it, but if we write it down and go through the process, it digs in deeper into our subconscious. It rests there. It finds a place to nurture in. And so, again, adding the words and everything else, I invite you now to just join me again, opening up our hearts, asking that question, what is mine to do? Maybe this is even an opportunity to bring in a word for the year. Whatever you're called upon, this is your possibility. So we go into the silence for a few minutes together. If you haven't already, you can begin writing down what came up for you. And in the moments ahead, the hours, the days, allow your imagination to continue that visualize, that conceive, to conceptualize for what's possible for your life. And again, I can't say this enough. It's the shining of our own light that gives other people the strength to shine their light too. And even though there might be naysayers or people that judge us for that or judge you for that. There are so many that are wanting to step into shining their best, being their best selves. And so it takes something for people to lead the way. It takes something for us to lead a unifying field of force that gathers others in so that we do have that unity. So for me, earlier today, my word of the year became strength. And so my word for 2020 is strength. And however, I was called in this moment to add imagination for how I will, I guess, be in 2021. I will be strength and imagination. And I'm so excited. I'm just so excited about that. Again, if you're comfortable, share in the chat. Let people know what's coming up for you. And let's just call a little bit of a closing to this now. Let's start our process for gratitude for this ceremony and for this group of people that have showed up together. So just enjoy now, join me in a nice couple of breaths in, and I invite you to breathe nice and slowly in through your nose, feeling your belly rise. Holding it. Letting go. And let's do another one together on 3, 2, 1, and in. Holding it. Let it go. Yeah. I want to share some of what has been shared here. Clarity, release pain, control, upset, calling in grace, freedom, ease, and joy. Serving others by becoming a clear channel of light and love. Yeah. Yeah. And again, you know, when I read these things, I always think, yes, we are. We are together all of these things. Happiness and freedom. We are all of these things. When I think back to 4 o'clock this morning when Patricia did the peace meditation. You know, we are all of these things together. It's beautiful. And I'm going to begin to close us out for today, inviting you again to continue your journaling, to continue to allow whatever comes into your imagination, whatever vision or visualization comes in, to continue to allow that to unfold for yourself. And you can see I put on the screen, there's a sacred white stone ceremony with Reverend Patricia tomorrow, 9 a.m., right here on the Unity of Nanaimo Facebook. And this is a great opportunity, again, to solidify what's possible for you in 2021, to lock it in tomorrow at 9 a.m. right here. Yeah, stepping into my full creativity, flow and joy, compassion, blessings for next year. Yeah, it's all beautiful. Yes, Leanne, thank you. Love and light. I'm only here to be truly helpful. Yeah. So let's take a moment now and just open up our hearts to this beautiful opportunity we had together. I know for me, I am so truly grateful that I am blessed to have this opportunity to lead something so beautiful for so many of you. It's truly an honor and a privilege for me to be able to share what's coming up for me, the teachings I'm learning, the path of ministerial school. And so I thank you for your grace and tolerance with me and your acceptance. And I look forward to serving my highest level, not only in 2021, but moving forward from that point on. And of course, Happy New Year to everybody. I'll share, Patricia says the Christmas concert will be up at 6 p.m. on January 1st. That's on our YouTube page. You can find it there. And yes, Happy New Year's to everybody. I am so grateful. All right. Stay blessed. All my love. Namaste.